Life is short and time is fast. There is no replay, no rewind for your life. Remember, if you want to enjoy life, you should utilize the time you have now. Good morning everyone and welcome to today's class. In this video, let us discuss the difficult numerical problems of Chapter 3, Machines. First, let us discuss the important formulas of exercise 3A. We know, in exercise 3A, mostly we deal with liver. So please do remember some of the important formulas. Number 1, mechanical advantage is equal to load divided by effort, or effort arm divided by load arm for levers. Number 2, load into load arm is equal to effort into effort arm. This is the principle of lever. Number 3, velocity ratio is equal to distance moved by the effort divided by distance moved by the load. Number 4, efficiency is equal to work output by work input multiplied by 100. Or efficiency is equal to mechanical advantage divided by velocity ratio. And also, please remember the formula for principle of moments, that is, in equilibrium, the sum of anti-clockwise moments is equal to sum of clockwise moments. Learn these formulas by heart. Without by hearting the formulas, nobody can do numericals. Read questions 2 or 3 times to understand properly and then apply in the required formula. First of all, let us discuss question number 4 of exercise 3A. Figure shows a lever in use. Find A part, to which class of lever does it belong? We have studied to find class of lever is very easy. Remember FLE. Here fulcrum is in the center, so it is of class 1st lever. Now B part, if AB is equal to 1 meter and AF is equal to 0.4 meter, find its mechanical advantage. We can see here that AF is equal to load arm, that is equal to 0.4 meter. And BF is equal to effort arm. BF is equal to AB minus AF, that is equal to 1 meter minus 0.4 meter, that is equal to 0.6 meter. So, applying the values in the formula, mechanical advantage is equal to effort arm divided by load arm, that is equal to 0.6 divided by 0.4, we get the answer as 1.5. Now the last part, part C, calculate the value of effort. We know mechanical advantage is equal to load divided by effort, and the load is given as 15 kgf, and mechanical advantage we have already found out as 1.5. So effort is equal to load divided by mechanical advantage. Substituting the values, 15 divided by 1.5, that is equal to 10 kgf. Now let us do question number 7 of exercise 3A. Question number 7. A 4 meter long rod of negligible weight is supported at a point 125 cm from its one end, and a load of 18 kgf is supported at a point 60 cm from the support on the shorter arm. If we draw the diagram of this question, we will get the diagram as this. Part A. If a weight W is placed at a distance of 250 cm from the support on the longer arm to balance the rod, find W. So as we can see, load into load arm is equal to effort into effort arm, the principle of levers. Here, load is equal to 18 kgf, load arm is equal to 60 centimeter, effort is equal to W, and effort arm is equal to 250 centimeter. So substituting the values in the formula, we get 18 into 60 is equal to W into 250. And W is equal to 18 into 60 divided by 250, which is equal to 4.32 kgf. Now, the B part, if a weight of 5 kgf is kept to balance the rod, find its position. Please note, usually students make mistake in this part. And why? Because usually students combine this part with section A. That means effort that we found out in the previous part and effort arm 250 centimeter was used only for part A. And we are not supposed to use those values in part B. Only we use the values given in the main part of the question. Therefore, load is equal to 18 kgf, load arm is equal to 60 centimeter. Here effort is equal to 5 kgf given in the B part. Find effort arm. We know according to the principle of levers, load into load arm is equal to effort into effort arm. Substituting the values, 18 into 60 is equal to 5 into effort arm. Therefore, effort arm is equal to 18 into 60 divided by 5, that is equal to 216 centimeter or 2.16 meter. Now C part, this part is very easy. To which class of lever does it belong? Please do remember FLE. Here fulcrum is in the center, so it is of class 1 lever. Now let us solve question number 10 of exercise 3A. Question number 10. Figure shows a wheelbarrow of mass 15 kg carrying a load of 30 kgf with its center of gravity at A. The point B and C are the center of wheel and tip of the handle such that the horizontal distance AB is equal to 20 cm and AC is equal to 40 cm. Please note it down. Fulcrum is at B, load is acting on point A, and effort is acting on point C. Let us solve part A. Find load arm. We know load arm is equal to distance from load to fulcrum. That is equal to AB, which is equal to 20 centimeter. Now part B. Effort arm. We know effort arm is equal to distance from effort to the fulcrum. Here it is BC and that is equal to 40 plus 20, that is equal to 60 centimeter. Now the C part, the mechanical advantage. We know mechanical advantage is equal to effort arm divided by load arm. Substituting the values, 60 divided by 20, that is equal to 3. Now, part D. The minimum effort required to keep the leg just off the ground. Please listen, here we have to find effort. So we can use the formula, mechanical advantage is equal to load divided by effort. Here load is equal to 30 kgf plus 15 kgf because total load is equal to weight of load plus weight of wheelbarrow. So we get load as 45 kgf. In the formula, effort is equal to load divided by mechanical advantage. Substituting the values, we get 45 divided by 3, which is equal to 15 kgf. Now let us do question number 11 of exercise 3A. Question number 11. Figure below shows the use of a lever. Part A. State the principle of moments as applied to the above lever. We know, according to principle of moments, in equilibrium, clockwise moments is equal to anti-clockwise moments. So, load into load arm is equal to effort into effort arm, which is equal to load into FB is equal to effort into FA. Please note, fixed point is fulcrum. So, load arm is equal to FB and effort arm is equal to FA. Now, part B. To which class of lever does it belong? Give an example. Please remember FLE. As effort is in the center, it is of class 3 lever. One another example of class 3 lever, we can write as sugar tongs. Now C part. If FA is equal to 10 cm, AB is equal to 490 cm, calculate number 1 the mechanical advantage and number 2 minimum effort required to lift the load. Load is given as 50 Newton. Here we know FA is given as 10 cm, that is effort arm, and AB is given as 490 cm. And if we calculate the value of FB, we get FB is equal to FA plus AB, that is equal to 10 plus 490, that is equal to 500 cm, which is load arm. So as we get load arm and effort arm, we can find out the value of mechanical advantage using in the formula mechanical advantage is equal to effort arm divided by load arm, substituting the values 10 divided by 500, which is equal to 1 by 50. Now see second part, minimum effort required. We know mechanical advantage is equal to load divided by effort, and the effort is equal to load divided by mechanical advantage. Substituting the values, we get 50 Newton divided by 1 by 50, which is equal to 50 into 50, that is equal to 2500 Newton. Now let us discuss some of the important formulas of exercise 3B. Most of the formulas remain same, like mechanical advantage is equal to load divided by effort, velocity ratio is equal to distance moved by effort divided by distance moved by the load, and efficiency is equal to mechanical advantage divided by velocity ratio. Please remember, in single fixed pulley, velocity ratio is always equal to 1. In single movable pulley, velocity ratio is always equal to 2. If we have one fixed pulley and other movable pulleys, then mechanical advantage is equal to 2 raised to power n, where n is the total number of movable pulleys. If we have a block and tackle system of pulleys, then velocity ratio is equal to total number of pulleys. And we have one more formula, mechanical advantage is equal to n minus w divided by e, where n is number of pulleys, w is weight of the lower block, and e is effort. Now let us do some of the important questions of exercise 3B. First let us do question number 2 of exercise 3B. Question number 2. A fixed pulley is driven by a 100 kg of mass falling at a rate of 8 meter in 4 seconds. It lifts a load of 75 kgf. Calculate Part A, power input to the pulley, taking the force of gravity on 1 kg as 10 Newton. Here we can see that we have to find power, and we know power is equal to work divided by time, and work is equal to mgh. So we get the formula as mgh divided by time. Substituting all the values, we know mass is equal to 100 kg, gravity is equal to 10 newton, height is equal to 8 meter, and time is 4 seconds. Substituting all the values, 100 into 10 into 8 divided by 4, we get the answer as 2000 watt. We know the unit of power is watt. Now part B, the efficiency of the pulley. We know the formula, efficiency is equal to mechanical advantage divided by velocity ratio. And mechanical advantage formula is load divided by effort. In the question, load and effort is given. Load is given as 75 kgf and effort is given as 100 kgf. So mechanical advantage is equal to 75 divided by 100, which is equal to 0.75. And velocity ratio is equal to 1. Please note it down. Velocity ratio for a single fixed pulley is always 1. So now efficiency is equal to mechanical advantage divided by velocity ratio. Substituting the value 0.75 divided by 1, which is equal to 0.75. Now part C. The height to which the load is raised in 4 seconds. We know the formula of velocity ratio. Velocity ratio is equal to distance moved by the effort divided by distance moved by the load. And we know velocity ratio is equal to 1 and distance moved by effort is equal to 8 meter. So, distance moved by load is equal to distance moved by effort divided by velocity ratio, which is equal to 8 divided by 1, and that is equal to 8 meter. Most of the numericals of this part are very easy, but diagram to draw block and tackle system of pulley is very important, and that will be surely coming for board examination. So please draw and prepare that thoroughly. Always use the formula for mechanical advantage, load divided by effort, if load and effort are given, and velocity ratio is usually constant. If distance moved by the effort and distance moved by the load is asked, use the formula velocity ratio is equal to distance moved by effort divided by distance moved by load. If number of strands of tackle supporting load is asked, that will be the number of tensions supporting load. And in the case of block and tackle system, it is equal to the total number of pulleys. Follow these instructions to do all the numericals. Now let us do question number 10 of exercise 3B. Question number 10. A block and tackle system has velocity ratio 3. Draw a labeled diagram of the system indicating the points of application and direction of load and effort. First, let us draw the diagram. As velocity ratio is equal to 3, total number of pulley is equal to 3. So, in the upper block, there are 2 pulleys and in the lower block, there is a 1 pulley. Effort is applied in the downward direction. Load is placed at lower block. Draw all the tensional forces acting on the string supporting load. That is 3 tensions and supporting effort 1 tension. Now, part A. A man can exert a pull of 200 kgf. What is the maximum load he can raise with the pulley system if its efficiency is 60%? Now here, efficiency is given as 60% and we know velocity ratio is equal to 3 because it is total number of pulleys. So efficiency is equal to mechanical advantage divided by velocity ratio multiplied by 100. Substituting all the values, 60 is equal to mechanical advantage divided by 3 into 100. Mechanical advantage is equal to 60 into 3 divided by 100. That is equal to 18 divided by 10, which is equal to 1.8. So we get mechanical advantage as 1.8. Now effort is given as 200 kgf. We have to find out load. So mechanical advantage is equal to load divided by effort, and load is equal to mechanical advantage multiplied by effort. So substituting the values, 1.8 into 200, which is equal to 360 kgf. Now part B, if the effort end moves a distance 60 cm, what distance does the load move? We know here distance moved by the effort is given as 60 cm. We have to find distance moved by the load. We know which formula to be applied. Obviously, formula for velocity ratio, that is equal to distance moved by effort divided by distance moved by the load. So distance moved by the load is equal to distance moved by effort divided by velocity ratio. Substituting the values, 60 divided by 3, that is equal to 20 centimeter. Now the final question, question number 11 of exercise 3B. Question number 11, you are given 4 pulleys and 3 strings. Draw a neat and labeled diagram to use them so as to obtain a maximum mechanical advantage equal to 8. In your diagram, mark the direction of load L, effort E, and tension in each strand. What assumptions have you made to obtain the required mechanical advantage? Okay, please listen. In the question, total number of pulleys are given as 4, and we have to get a mechanical advantage of 8. So this is not possible in a block and tackle system. So in combination of pulleys, there is one more type of pulleys, that is using one fixed pulley and remaining three as movable, as you can see in the diagram. Effort is applied in the downward direction, load is applied in the movable pulleys, tension are marked wherever it is necessary. And now to find mechanical advantage, we know the formula, which is equal to 2 raised to power n, where n is total number of movable pulleys. And here there are 3 movable pulleys, so mechanical advantage is equal to 2 raised to power 3, that is equal to 2 into 2 into 2, which is equal to 8. Now the question is, what assumption have you made? The assumptions made are, number 1, there is no friction in pulleys, and number 2, the pulleys and string are massless. So this is the end of today's class. Thank you and have a great day. May God bless you all.